OT7, OT7 Quanny, OT Sosa, you know. I just jumped off the porch with Dirty Glove Bastard.
You wanna write a book, how to get cash, call it OT. Pulled up with a bibs, look like Angelina Jolie. I just put a 3+1.
All right, y'all, so we got OT7 Quanny with us off the porch today. How are you feeling?
Everything good. We jumping off the porch.
Period, man.
We been jumped off the porch, but we gonna jump back off the porch today.
Now, let us know who you got behind you, because you done brought the gang out with you.
I got
you.
The guys with me. North Philly shit. Feel me? Straight from North Philly. Got my man Chaddy in the back. My man Mirzilla. Y'all know the rapper in our boy. NR3, that's in our boy right there. Y'all know who that is. If y'all don't know his name, in our boy, Instagram, YouTube.
Now, Quanny, you are from Philly, so tell us what part you're from.
North Philly. North Philly boy.
And how would you describe the culture out in North Philly?
It's rough, real rough. Like, it's hard to adapt if you're not from there. It's a lot of different stuff. Like, you will see a lot of shit. You might go to school, look across the street, you might see niggas playing basketball, then you might look across the street and see somebody trapping. Like, fresh out of school, you feel me? You only gonna do what you see, so it's hard. Like, if you weak-minded, that shit'll eat you up. But shit, it's different strokes for different folks, you feel me?
And how would you describe your upbringing there?
It's different. So it's different for me. Like, my upbringing, it was kind of, like, hard to adapt to, because it's like I said, you go from playing sports one day, the next day you in the streets, you feel me? So you got to be tough. Like, so my upbringing basically, like, basketball straight to the streets, football straight to the streets. I thought I'd be doing something else, and I looked up, and I'm right here rapping, and you feel me? So
in Philly, is it like you either got two choices? You know how they say you can either play sports or you could be in the streets?
No, I mean, it's more choices, but coming from where I come from, it's either one or the other, for like. You could take the choice to be an actor or a lawyer, whatever, but it, like I said, it's hard, like, because you're going to walk out your door, you're not going to see no lawyers. You feel me? Like, ain't nobody really living downtown. You live in the trenches or the projects. That's what you're going to see. You're going to do what you see. You feel me?
So growing up, you was playing football?
Yeah, I played both football and basketball.
I was going to say, you look like you played basketball.
Baseball, karate, all that shit.
And how was that for you growing up?
I will regret it, because I know a lot of my friends, like, I met a lot of my real friends, like, back in the day, playing football, basketball, built a lot of connections. A lot of the people I know now, like, I got some NFL friends that's still doing anything.
And speaking on the topic of Philly, like, I saw y'all a lot in the news this summer for, like, the violence that was going on there. So, what do you think is, like, the main cause of it?
I mean, misguidance. A lot of people don't got dads. They single mom, you feel me? Just imagine you trying to raise 4 kids. Shit like that. No food, no jobs. So they gonna go out and rob or whatever. You gotta think about it. Like I said, it's what you see. So like, a lot of kids not really trying to go to school and go to college. That's not really their thing. They see rappers. They wanna be rapper. They wanna be in football, do this and that. They don't know that you gotta go to school to be able to do that shit, you feel me? So it's not really in a lot of people, like, achievements nowadays. Like, when I was a kid, I wanted to get my diploma, you feel me? For my mom and them. These kids, like, you ain't gonna hear too many little niggas say that. Like, y'all wanna get my diploma for my folks, you feel me? They gonna say they wanna shoot something for somebody on their block or some shit like that. That's just how it go. That's just everywhere, though. They ain't just Philly. It's just being broadcasted there. That's it.
And would you say it's like a lack of male figures that can help guide the youth out there?
I mean, yeah and no, because I know a lot of niggas that dads was there, like, they still in
the
jail,
streets, yeah.
Still in the streets. So, like, it depends. Like, you could have somebody in your ear telling you to do the right thing and still go left. Like me, a lot of people probably think, like, damn, his dad wasn't around. Like, my dad missed some time, like, but he did what he had to do, you feel me? He still told me, yo, that's hot. It's gonna burn you if you touch it. And I still did it, you feel me? was different.
Now, getting back into your upbringing, you know we got to ask you, what age did you officially jump off the porch?
Shit. Probably like 13, 12, 13. Threw a little bad shit. Like, I still was playing sports and shit, but
yeah.
I walked across the street, you feel me? Like, where I'm from, it's two different sides of the project, you feel me? So, like, my grandma and my aunts and them lived on one side where the playground is at. And back in the day, that's where we used to hang at, like the kids of my age. But across the street is where the older people was at. And my grandma and me used to let me cross that street, you feel me? Once I turned like 12, 13, I wasn't trying to hear that shit. So I used to just go across the street. That's when one of my friends died. So a lot of shit changed for me. So that's when I feel like I jumped off the porch.
And did your grandma know, like, did she have any suspicion, like, you went ahead and took your ass over there?
I mean, she already had that suspicion. They already felt like that, like, because my family, like, big cousins, they used to tell me stay away from them, like, and, like, I was a, like, I ain't gonna say pretty boy, but I just, like, always liked girls, like, so I was trying to sneak girls and shit like that. They already knew, like, that he might, not saying if you own girls, at a young age, you gonna be in the streets, but just the route that they seen that I was taking, like, no, he wanna be around girls, he wanna do this and that, he gonna wind up taking that route, we gotta keep him away from that shit. And they try to do it with sports, but it just ain't work.
And what would you say was one of the biggest lessons you learned so far when it came to being in the streets?
Trust. Big lesson. Like, being big-hearted, shit bite you in the back.
Well, now that you are in the industry, you know it's a lot of people coming around that you got to deal with that you may not know. How are you handling that so far?
I mean, it's easy, but it's still kind of like iffy because you got to deal with that your whole life. It's always going, like, when you a person that, like, before I rapped, like a lot of these, like a lot of rappers, they might not have been somebody before they rap, so they just transition into a lot of shit they not used to, like, but when you just already the person that you is, like, people want to be around you and people want to, they going to try to use you sometimes. So I've been dealing with that before I start rapping, like, just people trying to slick talk, and you got to deal with it. That's just, so that was a little bit easier for me. It's not going to be easy for everybody though, but it was a little bit easier for me because I've been dealing with it. It's just different because I rap now.
Would you say you got kind of immune to it?
Yeah, you got to the time going, I mean, like I said, you, like, if you weak, like, weak-hearted, it might be hard, but, like, I'm a real man, so, like, I know how to deal with certain shit, you feel me?
So far, how has it been with you transitioning from being in the streets to now pursuing your rap career full-time?
It's still hard. Like, one day, knowing you waking up every day just grinding. It's still a grind, but it's a different grind, like, illegally or whatever you're doing, trapping every day, to not doing it, to saying like, well, I can't do that right now. I gotta sit in the studio. Shit like that. It's hard, like, to just, feel me?
Damn, like, what type of discipline did you have to get yourself to not go back?
I mean, I had a little cheat code because I had a son last year. So he just turned one. So more than anything, that's what tightened me up. More than anything, like, that helped me discipline myself.
Now, diving into your music career, how exactly did it begin?
What about Hobie's with the jail? What about Best Friends? He locked up right there. I used to be talking to him, like, on the jail calls. He'd tell me, like, by the time I come home, probably a couple of y'all probably be in here or dead, you feel me? Or just regular shit, like, so you gotta figure out something, what you gonna do? Like, what's gonna change you? And he just told me, like, rap, do something. And when he said that shit, it just stood out. Like, at first I laughed, like, I ain't a rapper, I don't know how to do that. But something just stood out about it, so I tried it. I wrote one song, well, I ain't even write it. I went to the booth and just recorded it. My friend said, damn, that shit hot, you gotta keep going. I was playing around a little bit, fumbled a little bit playing in the beginning. I wound up going to jail for like a year. And I thought about this shit, like, damn, maybe I should do it when I go home. And I was about to stop rapping, but I'm bored. He was in the studio, shit. He was recording. And he was gonna do his own song and shit. Me, him, and one of my other homies, his name Lil Nah. We was all getting on the song together. And I wound up writing a song, and it like did so many views that I couldn't stop. So it was like, fuck it. I just kept going. We all kept going. We built the name together. And then I just kept going, and we all just where we at right now.
Now tell us the meaning behind your name, OT7 Quanny.
Overtop. 7 days a week. That's me. You see me, I'm grinding every day. I will stop. 7 days a week.
And what would you say were some challenges that you had to face starting out into your music?
And what kind of challenges? Like, what you mean?
As far as, like, if you ever doubted yourself, like, because I know you're an independent artist, right?
Mm-hmm.
So what was that grind looking like for you, and what is it looking like for you now?
In the beginning, I ain't really had no help. We was doing it on our own, like me, Boring, Lil Nah. We ain't really had no help. Then we got a little bit of help from somebody. And then I started getting help from, like, a management, like, on that perspective. But in the beginning, it'll be hard because, like, you'll be looking at it like, damn, I'm putting all this money into it. I'm blocking everything, like what you said earlier, like stopping everything else that you're doing. All the other shit, you're like, damn, I'm putting all this time to the side. I'm grinding, I'm doing shows, I'm working, the money not coming in. So you're like, damn, you might feel like, I don't want to do this no more, you feel me? But that's like another thing, like I keep saying, like you just can't be weak-minded. Like you can't be weak, you can't let that shit get to you. You gotta keep rolling. You gotta roll with the punches, take what come with this shit.
And I do want to ask you, when did you start to see the buzz that you have now for yourself?
Probably like our second or third song in. Like it wasn't right now like how it is, but it just started going up. I just started adjusting to it as the time went. Like basically as the fans grew, I grew as a person, you feel me, as a rapper. So like I said, it's easy, like time will tell.
And when you was first like stepping into the music, did you ever doubt yourself at one point, like, man, I don't know if this is for me?
Probably like twice, once or twice. And my homies grind me up. They tell me, like, no, you tripping. You got kids depending on you, your folks, shit like that. It's just like turning your back on people and yourself. And you gotta look in the mirror, you feel me? That should eat you up.
So one thing that I noticed about you is like your fan base is really diverse. Like you have suburban kids, you got the street dudes, you got the women, like your fan base is for everybody. So how were you able to really cater to that diversity?
I just try to keep it real. Just be me. You feel me? Like I don't judge none of the fans. Like I interact with them, you feel me? Like I do that shit on my own. Like me and my team, we pull up, I talk to them, you feel me? Shit like that. So it's like, they like me for who I am. It's easy, like not saying, it's hard to say that about yourself. Like, yeah, it's easy to like me. You feel me? Like you telling somebody that, but like certain people, like they just got to it with them. Like it make people just like them, you feel me? Cause there's rappers that I listen to, like they just had that with them. Like that caught me, caught my eye, you feel me? Certain people just catch everybody's attention.
Well, who are some people that you listening to?
I listen to a lot of artists, like coming up.
Uh-huh.
Like coming up, I used to listen to like Young Jeezy, Yo Gotti, shit like that. Like I listened to a lot of Jadakiss as a kid, all that type shit. But like one of my favorite rappers probably Future.
What? Yeah, what you like about Future? You finna say Toxic?
No, he just changed. Like, he changed a lot of shit. You feel me? Like, he made a lot of shit cool. Like. Rappers, you feel me? A lot of people don't keep it real, they're not gonna say that, you feel me? But yeah, but I listen like right now, like, I listen to Babyface Ray, I listen to a lot of Philly artists too, like Pam Side Pop and our board. Listen to Lil Reek, people like that. I listen to a lot of Detroit people though, like, I like they sound, they got nice sound.
Yeah, when I was listening to your music, it kind of got that fast pace, like how they be doing in Detroit.
Yeah, I like that sound.
And speaking of your sound, how would you describe it personally?
In my own sound. I know everybody say that, but like, I really try to make it different. Like, I don't, like, a lot of people, like, say it's rap or drill or whatever they try to call it, you feel me? I be trying to make, like, money music, like, motivational shit, you feel me? Like, it's still a story behind it. Like, I'll tell what got me to this point. But I just talk about what I'm going through, you feel me? Everyday basis. And what somebody else going through.
So, you know, when do you feel like you make your best music?
I don't know. Sometimes when I'm alone, or probably, like, with him or her, probably with Boy, or with Nah, or, like, certain friends, like, might be, it's better, like, when I just got one or two of them around. Because a lot of my friends help me a lot. Like, people don't, sometimes, like, I don't like recording with a lot of people when it's a lot of noise and all that, like. But if I got, like, two friends that's right there that's going to help me, you feel me, I'd be good. That's when I make the best music. Because I don't hang around a lot of yes men. Like, a lot of homies, like, they not going to tell you, like, oh, yeah, that's bullshit. Or you slipped up a little bit. Or, like, me and my homies, like, I don't want to say like that. And my team, like, we perfectionists, like, we wanted everything to sound great, you feel me? So, I try to just record 24/7. That's what keep it rolling, you feel me? I try to record as much as I can.
And this is just a little off topic, but whenever you were first starting out, did you have a lot of people around you and it got smaller, or you still have, like, the same small group with you?
No, I still got the same people around me. I mean, I lost some people, but not due to, like, what you talking about. Like, I know where you're getting at, like, people changing or thinking I changed. Like, yeah, I go through that. Like, people treating me different, but, like, not to where the point, like, I cut them off because of that. Because, like, I already, like I said before, I was rapping. I was doing whatever I was doing. So just being on point in life, period, like, you got to watch out and watch your surroundings at all time.
So do you think it's best for rappers to keep a small circle with them? Because I know some people have, like, a huge-ass entourage.
I mean, it's different strokes for different folks. You feel
right.
Me? Like, if you know your people can't conduct themselves right, you feel me, then you're going to have to, it's either they're going to have to tighten up or they can't roll all the time.
Right.
And I got homies that I know I can't take certain places, like, they know that. They say they self, like, damn, bro, I wouldn't even want to go there. Like, I know how I would act, you feel me? But it ain't nothing wrong with that. Like, no matter where you take certain people, like, they just from the hood. You can't take hood out of people, you feel me? Like, certain people just like that.
I definitely feel that. And what would you say really keeps you motivated with your music career?
My family, all my friends. That's really it. Family, friends, and money.
I did notice that you did speak about your grandma yesterday, so I'm guessing, like, she plays a big part with you.
Mm-hmm.
So tell us a little bit about her.
My grandma always used to, like, want me to go hard at everything, no matter what it was, you feel me? Like, sports, school, whatever, she was there. She'd be on my ass no matter what. Football games, basketball, she there. My grandpa, too.
So they probably really excited for you with your music taking off like it is, huh?
My mom, my dad called me all the time, like, damn. I'm just sitting here watching your videos, shit like that. Like, he'd be happy for me. My mom, grandma, and grandpa. It's just hard for them adjusting to it. Like, not, like, hard in a bad way, but, like, they still, like, shocked. Like, damn, it's really you, like, on TV doing shit like that. Like,
right.
Like, my mom might call me, I'll be on the phone with her. It might be a label calling or somebody calling. I'm like, damn, I gotta talk to such and such real quick. And she just be shocked, like, damn, that's really crazy. Like, you really doing something with yourself, like, different. They didn't expect me to be rapping. Like, they expect me to play sports and shit like that. So this shit different.
Now, I do kind of want to touch back on Freely really quick. And I wanted to ask you, what would you say are the chances of a rapper making it out of Philly and being successful with it?
I mean, it's hard, but it's kind of easy right now, because if you got a good wave, like, they gonna stick to it. Like, if you putting out good music that they want, no matter what, they gonna stick to it. But it's just a lot of hatred. Everybody know that. Everybody don't really stick together, you feel me? So.
And as far as building a fan base out in Philly, are y'all, like, tough critics when it comes to the music?
I mean, Not tough, but you could say that, yeah, because like people in Philly really like listen, like, and they watch. They don't want to just hear it. They want to see it. Like, they want to see you doing what you talking about, you feel me? They want to see you fresh and fly and all that shit. They want to see you can't say something and they don't see it. They want to see it to believe it.
So you got to have that lifestyle with you, basically.
It's a lot of, like, that's why I said it's a lot of hatred. Like, everybody got flaws, you feel me? But, like, Philly is, like, they really observe. Like, they want to be all over it. They all over you. Like, if you saying you got money, they want to see the money. If you saying you doing this and that, they want to see it. You can't just be a kid that's trying to come up. So if you get that, it's a blessing, you feel me? Coming rocking from.
So are they pretty supportive of like the up and coming artists, or you kind of already have to have made it for them to see the potential?
I mean, I don't know, it's kind of hard. Like, I feel like they love me, like my fans love me, but right. It's a lot of hatred too. I mean, like, it's people that don't even know me that hate me. That's everywhere though, but it's kind of bad in Philly.
And what would you like to see change when it comes to the current music scene in Philly?
I mean, I don't really, to be honest, I don't really care. Like,
right.
Like, not to say it like that, but I don't really care about that. Like, nobody else, like, except for my, I don't care. Because at the end of the day, like, I can say what I want, we can say what we want, but I can't really change it. That's basically me trying to say I'm gonna change the streets or change, you feel me? Because
right.
Like rap is rap, but basically like the streets is in tune in Philly with rap. Like you gotta, in order to make it, you gotta make it where you at first, you feel me? Now if you not in the streets and you singing and you doing something else, like yeah, there's a lot of artists from Philly. Like look at Tierra Whack. We love her, you feel me? She ain't talking about doing nothing to nobody, you feel me? I love what she got going on, you feel me? Like, a lot of people from here that's doing it.
And getting back into your music, what was the first song that you dropped that went crazy?
Dead Rappers. Comeback was the first song, no, Comeback. Comeback was the first song. Yeah, me and Lil Nas and Boy and R3.
And when you recorded that one, did you know it was gonna take off like it did?
I didn't think I'd be sitting right here right now.
For real? Yeah. Damn.
I thought I'd still be on my block. Right
so now. What would you say was the recording process with that one?
It was easy. It was fast. Real quick. It was as soon as I came home from jail.
So, as I was getting into your catalog, you have a big buzz, but you don't have a lot of music videos on YouTube and you don't got a lot of songs on the streaming site. So how the hell were you able to build such a big ass fan base?
Instagram. Like, I do a lot of self-promotion, what I used to back around that time.
Mm-hmm.
So like 2-3 in the morning, people sleep. I'm sending my stuff out. So as soon as they wake up, they like, what's this? And they clicking it. And they want to see it. So I was making videos, like that was my whole little gimmick. I ain't wanna put no music on Apple Music at first, like iTunes and none of that. I ain't wanna put it on Spotify, none of that. I wanted to just drop videos. Cause I wanted to make sure if you wanna listen to my music, like you gotta see me, you gotta click my video. And I know like there's always ways around that. People gonna download it, put it on SoundCloud, shit like that, but that was my little gimmick. Like, y'all wanna listen to my music, go click the video. You gotta see me, you gotta see what's going on.
That's crazy. I do kinda want you to talk about the importance of promoting yourself as an artist.
You can't let your pride get in the way. A lot of people let their pride get in the way. Like I said, 2-3 in the morning, people sleep, I'm sending them my music. Like it was times people cussing me out, they waking up like, yo, I'm asleep, what you doing? You sending me music and shit.
Oh, you said they cussed you out.
They cussing me out, like, what you doing? I'm asleep, shit like that. I'm like, man, let's fuck that, you gonna hear this shit. I'm sending it out, everybody. Whoever I know, whoever followed me, anybody I follow, you just gotta get it out there. Ain't nobody else gonna really do it for you. Like for me, it's different, because I got real brothers that's gonna like be on my back. You feel me? They're not gonna let me slip up. And like, it's just hard to speak. Like, it's hard to speak on that because everybody not the same. You feel me?
Right.
So it's kind of hard.
Basically, like, promote yourself heavy.
Yeah, you gotta promote yourself. You got to, because nobody else really gonna do it. With me, it's different because I got brothers that's gonna send that shit out. Like, him or her, they gonna send it. Whatever I post, they gonna send it to the next person. They gonna post it. But sometimes you might just be the only person that's gonna. Nobody else gonna be over you. Like, how you gonna do it? You feel me? Nobody. That's anything you do. Nobody. You gotta be the one to put the work in. There might be people that's gonna help you along the way or be on your back about it, but you gotta be the one to do it.
Now, you are one of the, like, breaking artists in this new generation, which I consider Gen Z.
Mm-hmm.
How would you say the influence on Gen Z, basically, how does it differ from the influences that we had, like, back in the day?
It's different now because we got social media. Like, we got shit that they ain't have. They ain't really have Instagram, Facebook. So it was different. Like, the shows was different. People was going outside, like doing cookouts, doing parties, probably shit like that. Like right now, they not really doing it. Like they do shows and shit, everybody doing shows, but you getting paid to do shows and shit like that. People back then, they probably wasn't doing it. I don't know for sure, but they probably was getting paid, like the big people, like once it came along, but I know they started off somewhere else, you feel me? Wasn't no phones, you can't go live, you can't send it out, promote, none of that. They had radio play though. That's probably another thing that probably they was on the radio more because they didn't have that shit. So they
right.
had
I noticed
on
that
radio,
too.
So they probably had a lot of radio play and shit. So that was probably a better thing for them back in the day.
Now, what's something that you would want your fans to know about you?
Something that they don't know. Something that the fans don't know that I want them to know. I mean, if you listen to my music, you would know, like, I'm just grind hard. Like, I take advantage of this shit. Like, I put my everything into it, you feel me? So I want them to know that, like, I grind real hard for everything I got. Everything. I got a lot of help, too, though, from people. You gotta take advantage of that, you feel me? When you do get genuine people around, because there's not too many of them, you feel me? So you gotta take advantage of it. But.
And if I'm not mistaken, you could correct me if I'm wrong. Your music, does it keep getting leaked?
Yeah.
Like, what's been going on?
I don't know, man. They like it that much. They putting different songs together, mixing songs and shit. They be doing all type of shit. Man, that shit crazy.
And I'm sure your fans be putting pressure on you to drop some new stuff.
Yeah, they always do that.
And I did see your visual write a book. That shit has so many fucking, I cuss a lot, sorry. But
no,
it has
cool.
So many numbers yeah. on YouTube. So talk to us about the creative process with that video.
Write a book. The song, you know, it's crazy. Like me and my homies, like we didn't even think that song, I was gonna put it out. Like I didn't even think I was gonna pick one of those songs to get rolled out. But I recorded it and I did it in like 10, 15 minutes. Shit was fast, easy. Recorded it. Called my man Ish up. Like, damn, bro, I need you for this video. I'm gonna put it out. Got the location. Wound up going to like a photo shoot, like one of them type ones. Put it together fast. 3 different scenes, 4 different scenes. That was one of the best ones. That's one of my favorite songs.
That's the first one that I clicked on, too. Mm-hmm. That hoe is crazy.
It's because it got a hook and all. It's real catchy. And it's like I was kind of calm on the song, so it sounded good.
Now, I mentioned earlier the fans asking about new music. So, and you got this project coming out. Hellboy, you got to talk to us all about that.
Yeah, it was supposed to come out in November, but I'm going to push it back some. Probably drop like January, and I'm going to change the name. I'll probably put an EP out called Hellboy or something, but just some bullshit I had to change. I know they gonna be mad, but shit, it is what it is. They still gonna love it when it come out, so it'll be all right.
Now you say you was gonna change the name? Why you wanna change it?
I don't know. I came up with something different.
You can't tell us?
Not right now. I'll tell you after.
Now, what can we expect with this upcoming EP? We wanna know the vibes, all of that.
Like real trap shit. Like trap. I just wanna tell them how I came up. That's it. I mean, even when you look at it, everybody got grind. They might not be trapping, but you got grind. Everybody wanted to grind. Everybody had to grind, or they still grinding. So that's what I'm on heavy right now. I'm trying to give them that shit back. Real, like, Yo Gotti, Jeezy shit.
You got some features on there?
Yeah, I'm trying to put some shit together right now. I got features with him, Board, Pimps, Hot Pop, Lil Nas. My man, his name RB Cat, he from Philly. A couple Fadi Goon, Lil Reek, got a couple features.
And if you can, how has the recording process with this EP been going for you?
I mean, like I said, I try to record as much as I can.
Right.
So I ain't gonna say it's easy, but it's not hard.
But have you felt any pressure with this project to make it like the one?
I mean, yeah, because they want to hear the best shit, you feel me? So it's kind of like I'm giving them all the best music I got. But that's why I try to record as much as I can so I can have 1,000 songs to pick from, you feel me? 150 songs, shit like that. Like, damn, give them 10 right now, 10 to 15. And then still record, hold the other ones, but still record because I might come out with something better. You never know.
And how would you say that this project will differ from the singles that you have dropped?
You're probably not going to hear too much like Sosa type vibes or Virgil. You might hear like one or two songs like that, but you're not going to hear too much of that. I ain't going to say you're going to hear a lot of the same stuff, but you're not going to hear too much of that. It's going to be versatile, but you probably hear more like I Don't Know. I got a song called I Don't Know with Bore, like that type of flow. Like, what else I got out? I got a song called Okay Okay. A lot of my fans know about it. It's not out, but somehow, some way they got their hands on it.
But, look, your fans ain't playing about you. Like, they said, if you ain't putting it out, we gonna figure out a way.
Yeah, that's crazy. But one of them, like, one of them type vibes, that type vibe.
And who is some artist that you would like to work with in the future?
ESTJ. Trying to get up with him right now. Probably try to get him on there. ESTG, like Pooh Shiesty. They got a free Pooh Shiesty. Fuck with Pooh Shiesty. Young Boy, that's my favorite rapper. I know I said Future is, but that's like one of my favorite, like on some like him, Biggie, and like this generation though, Young Boy, my favorite rapper, him and Lil Baby.
I could definitely see you and Young Boy. Y'all's fan base together, like on y'all with y'all being on a single, that shit would be crazy.
Yeah.
Now, where do you see yourself as an artist for the next upcoming years?
Nowhere but up. Up. Magazines, TV, all that shit.
Ah, so you want to do some editorial stuff?
Like yeah, all that shit.
New York Fashion Week and shit.
Yeah, I like money. I love money. That's going to be money. I love money. We ain't gonna never stop grinding, never.
And before we wrap up, do you have any advice for any upcoming artists who may be looking up to you?
Promote yourself, never stop grinding. Never stop grinding, never, no matter what. Don't doubt yourself, don't let nobody doubt you. Anybody that's not for you or doubting you, you keep them around you, keep them from around you. My fault, cut that out. You keep anybody that's not for you or 100% in like you, you keep them from around you. Pay attention to everything. Keep grinding, never stop.
And before we wrap up, do you have any shout outs?
Yeah, man, it's too many people. I can't do names, but shout out to my hood. Shout out to my hood. Free the jails. Free all the jails. Free the whole Joes, all Joes. Shout out to my block, shout out to my management, shout out to my team, my whole team. Shout out to everybody that couldn't make it here today, but was with me the whole journey, the whole ride. I ain't got a name, y'all. I love y'all. Shout out to Jump Off the Porch for letting me jump off the porch again. Because we've been jumping off the porch.
All right. And do you want to talk about anything else before we wrap up or how you feel?
That's it. That's really it. One more part, just add this. Shout out to the guys that's behind me, too. Right here with me and my team that y'all can't see behind the camera. Shout out to everybody.
You wanna write a book, how to get cash, call it OT. Pulled up with a bitch, look like Angelina Jolie. I just put a 3 plus 1 in the Faygo. Blow a broski in the bag.